You think the government should go into people's houses if they don't want to give their guns back and, like, kick down the door and take them by force? Hi, this is Matt Miller from the Daily Caller News Foundation, and today we're asking people if they support a mandatory gun buyback like Beto O'Rourke suggested.
It will not be a voluntary program, to be clear. It'll be a mandatory buyback program.
It completely infringes the Second Amendment of the United States.
There are way too many guns in this country. We need to get rid of them somehow.
What do you think would happen if people didn't want to sell their guns back?
I think that they should be fined so that they comply with the law.
So what if they refuse to pay the fine? Like, you know, when it gets to that point, should the government, like, come in and kick their door down and take the guns, you think?
I think that's a little bit beyond the scope of my expertise, but in general, I support Beto O'Rourke's plan to buy back assault weapons.
So do you think that the people that are willing to voluntarily sell back their guns to the government are the dangerous people that are going to commit mass shootings or use their gun inappropriately?
Definitely not.
The Founding Fathers set up a system whereby we were able to protect ourselves from the federal government in case of tyranny, and I think that a mandatory buyback program completely flies in the face of what the Founding Fathers intended, regardless of how you feel about the guns themselves.
No, obviously not take them by force, but in a well-constructed way, yeah, I do think that they should be taken back.
Voluntarily, you think?
Yes.
And if they don't, what do you think, what happens, you think?
I mean, I think there should be some sort of legal, like, I'm not sure exactly the way it should be done, but there should be some sort of, like, punishment for the fact that they haven't given them back. I know that's a fine or something of that nature, but...
Well, I don't really think it should be mandatory. I think if there's incentive, like money incentive, to give back your guns, I think that should be enough.
Like, as much as I wish it would work, I don't think it would.
I'm not into guns myself. But it's, you take guns away and it's like almost castrating. AK-47 type guns are the big problem, so.
Assault style weapons?
Yes.
Okay, so what about like, what happens if nobody gives their gun back or people that don't give their gun back?
Well there will be people's mothers will take the guns and sell them back, so.
Their mothers?
They will, their grandmothers.
I absolutely believe that there is a real possibility that people will, not revolt, but they will fight back. I think that the people who own these types of guns that would refuse to give them back in the case of a buyback would most likely be the types of people that would maybe fight back if it came to that.
So then all the people that voluntarily sold them back, are those going to be like the mass shooters or the dangerous people that we don't want to have guns?
Of course not. It's their mother who says... You shouldn't have this gun, and they say it's my right as an American citizen. So
like the government coming into their house, kicking down the door, taking their guns. Like, you think that's a necessary step eventually, if the voluntary system doesn't work?
I think they should be on the table. They shouldn't be sold. Many of those guns shouldn't be sold in the first place.